There are times in our lives when we need help as we go on this journey. There are times, too, that when we need help, God will send someone who will guide us and give us help and directions to go. Dancing requires that we pay attention to the steps of the dance. And those who have danced this dance of life before, who know those steps so well, those who seeking and questioning and dreaming can lead us to also seek and hope and dream. Stay with us as we hear the story of the Ethiopian eunuch and how the Spirit of God guided him and Philip on their dance of life. Please join me in prayer. Holy God, we have gathered here once again on this Sunday morning to be in your presence and in the presence of one another. Help us, O God, to open our spirits today so that we can receive your word, so that we can be fed and nourished, that we can then go forth out into the world and guide others on this journey of faith. We just praise you and thank you, God. And may our worship today just truly lift our spirits. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'd like to welcome everyone today to Metropolitan Community of Church of Albuquerque as we continue in our virtual worship. Shout out to everyone on Zoom and a shout out to everyone on Facebook. And if you're watching this later on our, perhaps on our website or YouTube, thank you for joining us. Just kind of want to bring you up to date. I know things are slowly starting to open up and it feels like we're almost at the end of this pandemic, hopefully. We have a target date of opening up for worship the first Sunday in July. What we hope to do is this month of May, we're going to be putting the church back together again, getting the production room ready, going through run-throughs of how we're going to do worship live and also film it so those at home can watch. So we have some things to do to prepare for that. And during June, we're going to have like a soft opening So we'll have smaller groups of people that can come during the month of June and can give us, if you come, we're going to ask you to give us feedback on how the service went. Were there distractions? Were you able to worship? And then in July, the first Sunday in July, we'll have a great come back together again and worship together. So we'll keep you posted. Nothing is set in stone, but we're certainly hopeful and encouraged and excited. And I know it'd be so nice to see people again. It's just nice to see people. So thank you for being patient with us. We'll keep you posted. If you have any feedback or you want to help us in any way, please let us know. And thank you for being a part of this great faith community. We now have a reading from Ruth.
Good morning. A reading from the 8th chapter in the Acts of the Apostles. Then an angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go toward the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So Philip got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasure. He had come to Jerusalem to worship, and he was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to this chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. He asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone guides me?" This ends the reading from the 8th chapter of the Acts of the Apostles.
Thank you, Ruth. Acts very much reads like an action novel. It tells us the stories of the disciples and friends of Jesus, who were still calling themselves followers of the way, as they struggled to form a group identity. They were a very small community who were being heavily persecuted. And in those early days, those believers faced many challenges and risks. Our reading from Acts tells the story today of the Ethiopian eunuch. It is a story that helps us to look at the Bible with new eyes and hopefully see it from a different perspective. One of the most significant parts of my spiritual journey has been relearning how to read the Bible. I have had to find new ways to let these sacred words speak to me and to move in my heart. I've had to find ways to make the text sing again while also keeping my mind and my intellect engaged. So how do we read this text with new eyes? And what about this story still speaks to our lives in our community today? Well, I wonder what it was that led this eunuch, who was from Ethiopia, to go to Jerusalem to worship at the temple. Clearly, there was something in him that was compelling him to seek out a place of worship. But this person, the eunuch, would not have been welcome in the temple in Jerusalem. His status as a eunuch, someone who has either been castrated or born with ambiguous genitalia, would have prevented him from being able to even enter into the temple. So what compelled him to go to Jerusalem? What did he hope to even find there? Or what his experiences were? I think we can safely assume that he wasn't allowed to participate and enter the place of worship. So now he was returning home. And I'm sure he was probably feeling very rejected, feeling that he didn't fit in, and wondering if the whole trip was a waste. Now, some of us have had the experience of going to a church and hoping to worship, and instead find ourselves being turned away. Or if we're welcomed and allowed to attend, we're somehow made to feel uncomfortable, maybe because we weren't wearing the right clothes, or we didn't know when to stand or sit, or because of our gender identity or sexual orientation, we felt like they might have accepted us, but just as long as we don't hold hands or show any public displays of affection. And so we may have left church with a heavy heart, perhaps even crying on the way home, because we had so desired to worship with a group of people. I wonder if the Ethiopian eunuch was experiencing some of these feelings as he traveled toward his home. Maybe he was trying to find out why he had been rejected as he looked in the scriptures. Maybe he was looking for some kind of comfort. I wonder if he had turned to a favorite passage to reassure himself that he was a beloved child of God. Many of us have a favorite scripture that we turn to in our times of need, in our times of comfort. For some, it may not be a scripture passage, but a favorite poem or a novel. Or perhaps there is a song that speaks to you in the midst of your pain or joy. So back to our story. Philip was led by the Spirit and guided by the Spirit. And so he finds himself on the road where he encounters the Ethiopian eunuch reading scriptures. Philip sits down beside the man who is in the midst of rejection and confusion. And there Philip begins to answer the man's questions and to tell those wonderful stories of Jesus. Jesus, who was hospitable to everyone, even when it seemed somewhat reckless. Jesus, a man who ate with sinners and even touched lepers. Jesus, a man who purposefully made himself unclean in order to call attention to the arbitrary rules about who was in and who was out. Jesus wanted to challenge ideas about who is acceptable. And I imagined as the eunuch heard these words, they sounded sweet and comforting. And it probably confirmed what he had already known in his heart, that God loved him as he was. And then as they traveled on the road, they come upon some water. And the eunuch says to Philip, "Look, here's some water. What's to stop me from being baptized right now?" Now, Philip would have known the rules preventing eunuchs from worshiping. He would have known that this person he'd been talking to was considered to be unacceptable. Doesn't say anything. He doesn't say that this man has to go to classes or he has to wear something different. Philip just gets in the water and there he baptizes the eunuch. Philip, guided by the Spirit, and led by the Spirit. The eunuch guided by the Spirit and led by the Spirit. This passage shows us the power that can happen in our lives and the lives of others when we let down our walls and allow the Holy Spirit to move. We will find that we can have a deeper communion with God and with one another. There are times when the Holy Spirit will lead us to someone who needs the words that we have to comfort them or give them hope or encouragement. Or perhaps there's times when we need someone to minister to us just to say something that will comfort us or lift our spirits. As the Easter people, we can allow the Holy Spirit to guide us in our steps and trust that it will lead us into dances of resurrection and joy. We are a resurrection people. We are those who continually seek new life and new beginnings. And we, as a church, must be a place of knowing and growing and accepting love. As we dance into diversity and acceptance, I pray that the Spirit will guide our steps. Dancing requires that we pay attention to the steps that we do. Oftentimes, we can watch the steps of those who have danced this dance of life before, those who were seeking and questioning and dreaming. We find that they too can lead us to seek and hope and dream. Imagine someone whose steps you would like to follow. Look at how they choreographed their dance of life. Today, we're going to see a dance of a mother and a son. And when the pandemic hit, of course, the kids were out of school and the mother thought, what am I going to do with this active son? And so she said, I'm going to lead him and teach him how to tap dance. So I pray that this dance video will lift your spirits, dancing for all we're worth. And if I get We need some videos of you people, of everybody dancing. And if I get 5 videos from 5 people out there, I will do a dance video for you. Okay. That's my promise. So let us dance for all we're worth. Amen. God bless you. Amen. We now have the prayers of the people.
Praise the Lord. I love that, mother and son. Hello, all. I would ask you to join me in the prayers of the community and the people. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you and praise you. We praise you, Christ, our Savior, and we praise you, the Holy Spirit, for coming into us, comforting us, and guiding us. Lord, we bring the prayers to you. For first, the world. So many problems in the world right now with the pandemic. My tears go out to India because of 401,000 new cases yesterday. Father, be with them. Put your hand of healing on them, Father. We ask that. We ask that you would be with our government, with President Biden and all that are with him, and support our government, that you would guide them, Father. Guide them in your direction, not their direction, but your direction, to take care of our country. Father, we come to you and ask you for prayer for our people. We ask you for prayer for on June the 6th, that we might get together in our church again. Small gatherings, but yet gatherings of fellowship and just great joy of seeing one another again on a friendly, personal basis. And Father, I would ask that you would I lift up Randy Vanstone to you, that's having very serious health problems. Father, I lift up the person who's having legal problems and the situation that's happening on Tuesday. I just ask you to anoint them in this time. And Father, I do ask for you to lift up my husband and I as we are having many problems in the house we're selling. Father, just put your hand on it and we trust in you to guide us. We lift up our pastors to you, Father, and all of our leadership to you, that we would fall under your guidance and your jurisdiction, Lord God. Lead our mayor, Keller, in his decisions that he needs to make for our city, for our governor. We lift all these up to you, Father. And most of all, equally the same, we lift up all the prayers of the people. Those that are unspoken, Lord, we ask that you would anoint them and bless them in this time, this very, very difficult time in our lives. We praise you. We give you the glory and the honor through the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Amen.
page, I seek you, Lord. My spirit yearns for you, O living Word. Break now the bread of life, O Lord, to me, that hid within my heart your word may be. Mold now each inward thought from self set free, and let my steps be all controlled by thee. Bless now the truth, dear Christ, to me, as you once blessed the bread by Galilee, then shall all bondage cease, all shackles fall, and I shall find my peace, my all.
Amen. And always thank you, music team. Just now in Facebook a few minutes ago, somebody shared that they went to a church and were turned away because of who they were, because of who they loved, because they were gay. And that Ethiopian eunuch on that road, as Pastor was saying, perhaps felt that same exclusion. So as we come to the table, we wonder, is there a place? Is there a chair for me? Is there a place for me? Will I fit in? And the answer is, and always has been, yes. Because on the night when our Lord was to suffer, he gathered with his friends and his followers, and he took bread in his hands, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to them, and he said, "This is my broken body given to you. Take and eat." And then he took a cup of wine, fruit of the vine, and he blessed it. And he gave it to them saying, "Take this and drink. This is my blood, the blood of the new and the everlasting covenant." And as often as you come together and you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, remember me. I invite you now, if you have some element, to receive those elements now. Let us pray. Holy God, we give you thanks for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who reminds us that we are loved by you with an unconditional love, and that you have a place prepared for us. You have a place for us in your very heart. We pray a blessing upon these humble elements, that they might become for us our spiritual food and drink, that which we need on our journey each day. We give thanks for you, and we pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. And God bless.
The eyes of the blind, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you. None like you. God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? What could stand against? Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? What could stand against?
Ruth?
Yes, hello. Today I'm going to be asking today several ways that for our offerings. And of course, giving, it's one of our important part of Christian walk. And it helps with keeping our building breathing, and as well as other things as provided for, you know, the growth of our church as well. There are several ways that you can give through online at mccalbuquerque.com/give. Of course, there's also PayPal. You can send it to PayPal at mccabq.com. Of course, the check, money order, to mail it in to MCC of Albuquerque at the address that you see. And then of course you can give us this call as well. Just a few other things I wanted to bring up with the donations and offerings that we get is this coming Saturday, we are going to be doing a meet greet, that's what I call it, of landscaping, xeriscaping of the church. So come on out. We have had several people call me, and I thank you. And I know there's a few people that are new in town, and they are excited to come out and help pull some weeds with us. So just come on out, and we'll do that. Lunch and drinks will be provided. We all start at 8 o'clock, and I hope to see you guys out there. And have a good week, everybody.
Thank you, Ruth. Well, another Sunday. It was wonderful to worship with you today. I hope your spirits were lifted. Stay with us at 11:15. We will be doing a gathering at the stream as we continue to talk about probably the Ethiopian eunuch. And I know many of us who identify as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, non-conforming gender, sometimes we've been excluded, but lots of other people have been excluded too. And this is a great church. If you've ever been excluded from anything, you'll find a place here. There's always a place for you at the table here. Join us at 11:15, and now pray with me, please. Holy One, Justice Seeker, God of creation, open us to learn new steps of faithfulness. Give us courage and patience. Come and dance with us. Engage with us, O God, as we seek you, so that we too can be risen with Christ and in Christ. Be with us now as we go our ways. In your name we pray. Amen. God bless you.